Good morning, everybody. What a great morning indeed it is to be out here with you all today. I love groundbreakings. I love it. It's like baking a cake. You have to put it in the oven for a while, and then a few months later, I mean, well, a cake a few hours later or minutes later. I haven't baked a cake before. I don't know what I'm talking about. But but as it comes to baking a cake in a metaphorical way of building out affordable housing, the groundbreaking is the start. And it gives us something that we aspire to see in a few months. And I'm going to drive by this often and see it come up and continue to think about the lives that are going to live here, the families that are going to be blessed with housing and health care, two vital needs that we have in our community. And so to you guys that are doing this project, for all of us, this is a blessing. It's going to add to people's lives and add to our city. And so I'm just thankful, and as was mentioned by Eamon, that we are gonna build or preserve 20,000 units of affordable housing in this city over the next 8 years. And I didn't wanna come out as mayor and say we're gonna do this millions of dollars or this billions of dollars. I'm about the number of units, because the units represent a family to me. And my goal is to do that, and all of you together are helping to do that as you encourage others to build affordable housing, as you come to Invest Atlanta with Dr. Clementich and Vicky and the whole team to get your supportive packages, your inducements and financial support. As we work together to build and preserve affordable housing, it's gonna make our city better. Because we recognize that the need is urgent. This is an urgent need to have more affordable housing. The cost of housing and everything continues to increase in our city and in our world. The cost of living, of housing is up double digits. It's about 65% increase over the last 10 years. That's how much housing costs have increased in Metro Atlanta over the last 10 years, 65%. And so now people are spending well over $1,500 a month just for a one-bedroom apartment in Atlanta. And our incomes, unfortunately for low-income folks, have not increased by that 65%. And so now you have a challenge where the housing stock is low and incomes are not keeping up with it. So that's why I'm so thankful for what you guys are doing here and these robust partnerships that we have. That's the best way to get projects done. The best way to develop out this city is to build partnerships and work with groups like this to get it done. That's also why I established a housing strike force. This is a creating a one-stop shop inside of city government where, whether you're dealing with Atlanta Housing Authority property, city property, MARTA, Atlanta Public Schools, the Beltline, the Land Bank, the Land Trust, all of us are gonna work together to make these properties available, these assets that are pretty much government controlled. And I've asked these groups to not work in silos, but to work together because of the urgency of these developments. And that's why I'm so excited to be here today at Macaulay Station. This is about partnerships and people working together. I'm excited about the workforce opportunities, the workforce housing opportunities that are coming, and for it to be permanent supportive housing. Permanent. Permanent is important, not just 10 years or even 15 years. This is about permanence, where Mercy Care and the teams here are gonna make sure that we have affordability for generations to come for our vulnerable citizens, and to partner that to access to healthcare. Projects like this don't come together easy. You have to work hard at it with the right partners. And it's good to see our city council member, Bhatiara here, Liliana Bhatiara, to be in our midst as we're in her district. And so these joint ventures bring together public and private partners. And so I know Invest Atlanta has a role to play in this. Of course, our Georgia Department of Community Affairs, DCA, Commissioner Nunn, as well as Truist. Truist has been a phenomenal partner in helping us build out affordable housing to finance it. And then Penrose and Penrose Management and how you guys bring things to bear. And of course, last but not least, Tom Andrews and the folks at St. Joseph's Healthcare System, Mercy Care, who saw the need for the sort of housing and health model that we're looking at. And then everybody just got busy to make it happen. That's hard work, and so I'm looking forward to today and how we've done this groundbreaking, and now I'm going to be looking forward to that cake being baked, which is going to be that ribbon cutting that we'll have in months to come. So thank you all. I'm excited, and let's continue to get to work. And all of you developers out there, keep getting your shovels ready. We got 20,000 units to build, so don't ever put your shovels down. Just keep going to the office at Invest Atlanta and our partners to keep getting your supportive packages. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. Didn't realize how tall you were. So I just wanted to say a few words before we get to our next speaker, and to start with, you know, cultivating successful community-based partnerships is really the foundation of Penrose's success and our reputation. And we are especially proud to be partnering with St. Joseph Health System, Mercy Care, on this transformative healthcare and affordable housing project. Now, I wanted to take some time to describe how Macaulay Station in this partnership is unique and really one of a kind. And to start with, Macaulay Station is really part of a master plan community. It's a campus, and that includes expansion of Mercy Care's clinic space that better serves the healthcare needs of Atlanta's low-income population. Macaulay Station will be 170 units, a mix of studio, one and two bedroom units, with an average affordability of 60% of area median income. I wanted to talk a little bit about that for those of you who may not live in my affordable housing world and talk that lingo, but a 60% of area median income equates to a two bedroom unit. It would be a household of two that could make up to $46,320 a year. And they could live, we'll be able to live at Macaulay Station for an average rent of around $950 a month. And to put that in perspective, thank you. To put that in perspective, on my way here today, I stopped off at one of the wonderful market rate communities in this submarket and just went into the leasing office to see what a two bedroom would go for today. $3,100 a month. So that just gives you a little perspective. Also, as the mayor mentioned, we will have permanent supportive housing and a type of housing, 30 units here, for individuals who have special needs and need supportive services. And that was financed by the city's Partners for Home program, and Atlanta Housing has wrapped a project-based rental assistance contract around that. 10 of the units, 170 units, will be master leased to Mercy Care as respite units here. And then Macaulay Station will include and be adjacent to numerous amenities that we like to say will create a lifestyle where these households will thrive. We're adjacent to the King Memorial MARTA station, access to jobs throughout the metro Atlanta area, walking distance to the Atlanta Beltline, walking distance across the street from the Martin Luther King Recreational Aquatic Center. And then the interior amenities that we'll have for the residents will include fitness center, business center, we'll have lounges. We're gonna have a rooftop deck with views of downtown and midtown skyline. And what's really amazing about this project, this deck will sit on top of a parking structure where we will share parking. There will be 315 spaces shared with Mercy Care Clinic staff and the residents in the units. So this is just phase one, and Mayor, let me say, with your continued support and the support of our partners you're gonna hear from later today, we're coming back with another groundbreaking right where we're sitting here today. Phase two of Macaulay Station, so I'm putting it out there. Phase two will be up to 100 units, Mayor, of affordable senior housing. So stay tuned for that, everyone.
I'm Liliana Bakhtiari, Councilmember for District 5. I apologize for being late. I do not have the same valet service as the mayor. Or the same navigational system. But there's a lot I could talk about today. You've heard all of the facts. I think one of the things I actually want to talk about is the community and the people that make it up. Tom and I first became familiar with each other when we were working at the beginning of the pandemic, assisting unsheltered populations off the street into housing when we had the healthy hotel, the Ramada. And my father's known him longer than that because my dad is a pharmacist. I'm very navigationally challenged, but next to the old Butler YMCA. And so they've been familiar with each other a bit longer. And one of the reasons that this development is so important to me is because you hear, obviously the affordability piece, and thank you, because I can barely, I would, if I hadn't bought my house in 2010, I wouldn't be able to afford those two bedrooms that you're talking about now. And the big thing here that I appreciate about Mercy Care and the people that are discussing this housing development is we talk about the unsheltered population. And if you've been over on Edgewood Avenue in this community, the community that is adjacent to where this development will go, you see the severe poverty, the mental health struggles, the people that are profiting off of keeping those people addicted to drugs and alcohol. And the thing is that we always punish or condemn the people that we see on the street. I can't tell you how many times I've seen people step over those bodies, the people that are trying to sleep because they have nowhere to go. And we instead of blaming the people that are profiting off of keeping those people in that trap, we go after the ones and we go after the people that are actually on the street. And there are people that profit off of keeping them that way. One of the things I appreciate about Tom and about Mercy Care and about Catherine is that there's always been compassion and humanity when we discuss the people who need the most help. My vision, my goal for this area, in partnership with everybody here who has done this work, is to disrupt that poverty that we see. In fact, I'm excited that I'll be partnering with Catherine and Mercy on converting Selena Butler Rec Center into a walk-in center. I think I've told you about that, Mayor. And trying to disrupt the drug trafficking we see in those parks and trying to help the people off the street. We have Grady right there. We have GSU, who's a great partner. We have Mercy Care here. We have all these affordable housing developments that are going into a community that was the cradle of the civil rights movement, but where poverty hasn't changed in decades. And so this type of housing development is going to be revolutionary for this community. And the fact that we continue focusing here and continue to bring resources here, it's not a one-off, it's not a silver bullet. And so I'm so grateful that we have partners like you all, like the Russell family, like Mercy, like St. Joseph's, like Invest, and of course, my forever mayor. And hey, Vicky. And that we have the ability to be transformative in the lives that we talk about, because again, it's not just about the building. We get to sit here under this beautiful air-conditioned tent. I don't know how y'all are doing it over there, but the communities that we're talking about housing are out there suffering on this pavement with no water, with no housing, with nothing, dealing with hostile architecture and infrastructure. And so I'm just very grateful that we're building this here. I hope that this is one step of many. As you heard the mayor say, don't put down your shovels. But you have a partner in me always, and I will do whatever work is required to support more housing coming into this community. And I will always, always, always continue to humanize our under-resourced and our unhoused populations. And I encourage you all to do the same. But thank you all for having me, and I'm looking forward to getting this thing built. So thank you all.
And I just want to say it's super exciting to be here today. And, you know, I mean, you mentioned it really does take a lot of people to make this happen. And so I just have to recognize the folks at Invest Atlanta. So Vicky, who's here, and if you ever need a project, she is wonderful. Kiara, Paige, Krista, Bernita, Yolanda, and Mary Willis. Our trustee and Mike Casamias wanted to say thank you, because it does take a village to be able to move these forward. What's even more exciting about this particular project is we know a couple things. First is an average person or average family spends about 63% of their income on housing and transportation. So if you're able to lower those costs, and we're right here next to a MARTA station, we'll be having affordable housing, then you are making the biggest impact you can on families. And that's why this project is super exciting, one. And two, I hope that it really sets a tone, Mercy Care, I hope you set the tone for others to see that this is really our form of employee housing, right? They're providing housing for the people they serve. And I think this can set the tone for more companies who are telling us now, we're hearing, before when we talked to a company, they'd say, oh, my number one issue is workforce. I got to ensure I have the right workforce. Now we're hearing a couple companies say, hey, Eloisa, we're having some concerns with affordable housing. So now we're putting it back on the companies and saying, would you invest in housing? And why don't you partake in this to be part of the solution? So now I have a great example to show on what's happening here and how a company has taken housing and really moved it forward to that next level. So I'm excited, Mercy Care, for what you're doing and the model you're gonna set of bringing healthcare, housing, and supporting your own employees here at this fabulous facility. I'd also like to recognize the Eastside TAD. This is a tool that we're able to use to create these affordable housing units and really look for the partner as a partnership of entities like CAP who are really helping us really drive some of this effort. And if you ever have a TAD question, Jennifer is the best person to talk to back there. She can help you with that. So with that, I just want to say how excited I am. I'm going to keep it short because I see those fans going and want to thank the mayor and the council member for their continual partnership in these efforts. Thank you.
One, two, three, toss.